Hey guys, happy Valentine's Day. Where's Ruby? Ruby, happy Valentine's Day. Nora.
Hi, Nora.
Nora.
Oh, hi, Mia.
Amelia. We've got a special Valentine's for you that we're going to share with you. Hope you're going to like it. Hold on.
Love you. It was almost Valentine's Day, and no one had sent Charlie Brown a card. Nobody ever sent Charlie Brown a card. "What are you waiting for, Charlie Brown?" asked Lucy. "Valentine's," he said. Charlie Brown always hoped his luck would change. "Well, good luck," said Lucy. "You're gonna need it." But nothing ever changed for Charlie Brown. On Halloween, he always got a rock. And on Valentine's Day, he didn't get anything. Charlie Brown opened his mailbox and peeked in. It was empty, as usual. While Charlie Brown waited for Valentine's, Linus waited for his teacher, Miss Othmar, to notice him. "Did you hear that, Sally?" Linus exclaimed. "Miss Othmar said my name. She likes me." "Oh, Linus," sighed Sally. "Miss Othmar was taking attendance. She said everyone's name." Sally frowned. How could her sweet Babu have a crush on someone else? Linus found the biggest heart-shaped box of candy in the store. "Who's that?" asked Violet when she saw the enormous Valentine. "It's awfully expensive, isn't it?" "It's for Miss Othmar," Linus explained. "The amount of money you should spend equals the amount of affection you have." Violet wasn't sure. "It's a bad idea to fall in love with your teacher." "Who said I was in love?" Linus said. "I just happened to want to kiss the very ground upon which she walks." Sally saw Linus leave the store with a big smile on his face. "Look at that big box of candy Linus bought for me," Sally gushed to Violet. "It's amazing." Sally rushed off, deep in thought over what she should buy her sweet Babu in return. Violet didn't even have time to tell her that the candy was for somebody else. The whole gang was excited about the school's Valentine's Day party. Schroeder was in charge. "Each student will drop the cards into the box. I will hand them out at the party." Sally asked a question. "Can we make our own Valentines?" "Yes," agreed Miss Othmar and Schroeder. Homemade Valentines were very nice. Charlie Brown grinned to himself. "This is it," he said to himself. "With all these kids, surely someone will give me a Valentine." Sally wanted to make a special Valentine for Linus. Charlie Brown tried to teach Sally how to make a paper heart, but she ended up with a diamond-shaped hole right in the middle of her paper. Snoopy was having a much easier time. He folded his paper, then snip, snip, snip. Snoopy's Valentine was incredible. It even played music. Charlie Brown folded a piece of paper. He handed the scissors to Sally and said, "You can do that. Just cut out some hearts and moons." But instead of a beautiful Valentine, all they created was a pile of scraps. The night before the party, Charlie Brown stayed up late making Valentines. He walked into the classroom with a fluttery, hopeful feeling in his heart. He was going to get so many Valentines, he'd brought an empty briefcase to carry them all home. Schroeder told everyone, "It is time to put their Valentines in the box. Then we'll have our party," he said as the kids rushed up with the Valentines. "Are there any cards for me?" Charlie Brown asked. "I don't know," Schroeder said. Why are you carrying that briefcase?" "I'm going to put my Valentines in it," Charlie Brown explained. He sure hoped his briefcase was big enough. Linus's heart-shaped box of candy didn't fit in the card box. "May I deliver this Valentine instead?" he asked. Miss Othmar said that would be lovely. Linus felt dizzy with love. "Miss Othmar said my Valentine would be lovely." Sally gave her sweet Babu her homemade card. Linus said, "Thanks," and tossed the card on the desk. Sally wondered what Linus was doing. "He forgot to give me my big box of candy." Then she perked up, "Oh well, when he gives it to me later, I'll give him a big kiss." Schroeder began calling out names and handing out Valentines. Charlie Brown wished he had brought two briefcases, just in case. Charlie Brown waited and waited, but Schroeder did not call his name. "Has there been a mistake? Did you see my name on any cards?" asked Charlie Brown. "When I see one with your name on it, Charlie Brown, I will give it to you," said Schroeder. "Did anyone send Charlie Brown a Valentine card?" asked Violet. "Why would anyone bother to do that?" replied Lucy. After every card had been passed out, Charlie Brown peeked in the empty box. It was true. There were no Valentines for him. Where was Miss Othmar? Linus wanted to give her his Valentine, but she was nowhere to be found. "She just left," said Schroeder. Sally saw Linus running toward her with the Valentine. "My sweet Babu is coming," she cried. Sally closed her eyes, puckered up, and waited for her kiss. It never came. "Linus is gone. Where is he?" Sally wailed. "He's looking for Miss Othmar," Violet said. "Miss Othmar is with her boyfriend," Charlie Brown said. "But Linus has my box of candy," cried Sally. Miss Othmar and her boyfriend drove away just as Linus got there. Linus was crushed. Miss Othmar didn't even notice him. Linus wiped away his tears and walked to a bridge. He ripped open the box. "I'm such a fool," he cried. "I spent all of my money for nothing." Then piece by piece, he threw the Valentine candy over the bridge and shouted, "This is for romance." Snoopy and Woodstock waited below the bridge for the candy to fall. The next day, after Valentine's Day, Charlie Brown eagerly checked his mailbox. "Maybe my Valentines just didn't get here on time," he said. "Maybe they're waiting for me right now." He opened his mailbox. Snoopy popped out and gave Charlie Brown a big smooch. "I hate Valentine's Day," shouted Charlie Brown. Then he shut the mailbox with a clang. The gang showed up. "We feel guilty about not giving you any Valentines, Charlie Brown," said Violet. "I crossed out my name on this one and I'm giving it to you." Schroeder was mad. "Now don't give your used Valentine just because you feel guilty. Charlie Brown doesn't want..." "No," interrupted Charlie Brown. "Don't listen to him." He grabbed the card and clutched it tightly. His friends really did care. Charlie Brown and Linus hadn't found love, but at least they had each other. "Schroeder isn't too happy that I took Violet's old card," said Charlie Brown. "But at least I got my first Valentine. Maybe next year I'll need three briefcases to hold all my Valentines." Linus sighed. His friend would never change. Happy Valentine's Day, Charlie Brown. The end.
Bye. I hope you guys liked that. Have a happy Valentine's Day, and there is our friend.